be with you this morning. We don't have any activity in Australia, by the way, so I have to correct that. But it's absolutely true, and I was very attentive to the statement by Mrs. Booth this morning in the opening session that I think since the beginning, and since I took this job 2 years ago, we have really believed that in everything we would do, partnering with other actors, not only with mobile operators or with technology providers, but at least also with transport actors, with banks, would be absolutely key to the success we could get. And this is what I'm going to cover briefly this morning. And to not be generic or dogmatic about this, because we are not, what I decided is to walk you through some of the latest developments in the last year and to highlight a few of the partnerships we've either engaged or, let's say, brought to another step. So first of all, today I'm going to concentrate my, my speech on mobile money first, where today we run operation in 13 countries, and then on NFC, where we decided to focus our efforts for developing services on four main markets, which are France, UK, Poland, and Spain. So Orange Money, as all of you know, is an end-to-end mobile money solution, mainly for unbanked people. And there are three pillars to it in the proposition. The first one is an electronic money account, which in most of the case we offer to customers which were until then deprived from the access to financial services. There is a functionality to transfer money, which is very an important need in this market, and it's also a payment tool. I think what I would like first to comment about partnership on this Orange Money story is that, to be honest, when we started Orange Money, it was really built on, let's say, cost and technology synergies with the assets of the telco operator. So, to some point, it was not a partnership issue. We just had partnership with one main bank, which addressed the regulatory issues to which we have to comply, for sure. But most of the technology was closed loop. As a payment solution, you would describe it, let's say, mainly as closed loop. And because of, let's say, a very robust, simplistic approach on basic needs, we were able to develop these services. What is very interesting is that we have now reached a level of development, which was also this morning quoted by Anne Bouvreau in the opening sessions. She mentioned that there are 9 programs in the world with more than 1 million active customers. We have another, let's say, measure to that, which is what we call the 10% barrier. Okay, mobile penetration in most of the cases of the market is close to 100%, and what we know in consumer services is that when you overpass 10% penetration of a given service, then this service is very, let's say, likely to become universal. And today, we have already one market where we have passed this 10% active penetration of mobile money out of our total customer base. And to be honest, we have passed it for some months. And there is a second market for which we are not yet there, but we are absolutely sure, let's say, by the numbers and the vigorous dynamism, that we'll get there. So because we are there and we passed the first, let's say, development step, we have to think how we enrich the proposition to our customers. And this is basically what is stated in white today. And so you can see that this business is turning a partnership business in its execution to many regards. The most, let's say, obvious vision is on the right. It's for payment, because today we are working a lot on facilitating bill payment, and this goes to, for example, we had a partnership with Canal Plus throughout Africa for prepaid television service. We partner with universities in local markets. We partner with utilities, mainly for water, electricity, gas. We even have now a partnership with a bus, let's say, a transport company in one market on which we are exploring, let's say, a mobile journey, a bit like an NFC-based one, but based on mobile money. And there were two developments this year, which were both innovations, but also met commercial success from day one, and I wanted to share them back with you. So the first one is international money transfer. I think it's a bit irrelevant to talk about international money transfer because what we are doing is in the same currency zone with the same central bank, which is the one for West Africa, so with the France CFA. We have extended the possibility to do peer-to-peer transfer service inside the country to the countries which are in the same monetary zone. So in this case, we have gone, let's say, in a pure, we are addressing money transfer in a pure mobile-to-mobile, wallet-to-wallet dimension, and just amongst Orange customers. And the development of this is absolutely fantastic. Well, yesterday was a special day for the people in this region, but to give you just a very fresh number, we achieved yesterday in one day the number of transactions which was our total for August, which was the first full month since launching this service. So yesterday we did that in one day. It's also very interesting because it shows one of the benefits of mobile money, which is people are able to do much more transactions, not to have to do, I would say, for example, one transfer of 100 or 200 euros to optimize the cost of transferring the money. They can send 10 euros one day, then 20 euros, optimize their own, let's say, pocket money, and be in a much more simple journey also, and a much more convenient approach. The other thing which I would like to highlight, which is really a partnership, it took us, let's say, 18 months of work with Visa to get there. We announced that in a Mobile World Congress in 2012, is the Visa debit card on an electronic money account in Botswana. So we launched that this summer. This is challenging on the other sense, because you could say, well, you have a complete mobile money platform. Why do you, let's say, introduce back plastic into it? We just face that for our customers, it is more convenient to get the best of both worlds when they can access, for example, a range of ATMs, which are quite developed in Botswana. And I think it's for us also very interesting that as a testimony that we need to be very open in the development of services to what we will do and what we will not do. And in the end, for us, just let's say what brings value for the customer will make the final call. Okay, so I'm not giving too much numbers about the development of our mobile money program because we will be issuing a press release in the next days. But basically one thing which I can say is that we published in July, some numbers about the evolution of the transaction value when we published the group financial results for H1. And if you look at these numbers, they were already double what we presented last year in the previous edition of the Mobile Money Summit. So we have far more than doubled the volume of the business in 1 year. So NFC. So NFC, I will take it one by one because I could be also extending my time. So this year, after Nice in 2011, which was very much commented, we opened three local transport services. We opened in Caen, in Strasbourg, and in Argenteuil. Well, Argenteuil is a small, not so small, but let's say compared to Paris, it's small, city in the outskirts of Paris, and it has, let's say, the virtue of a proof of concept also for Paris transport authorities. What I think is very interesting in this approach is that 2 years ago, there was a global plan for regional transport, and basically there were 15 cities putting up their own plan to move to mobile and to implement NFC. Now, let's say the latest development and the hottest one is what we call the ABC project, which is in France, it stands for Application Billettique Commune, so that would mean Common Ticketing Application. So that means that there has been an initiative to form a single project which will be able to deliver on mobile a ticket for any regional service in France, okay? So this is both addressing two factors. The first one is to mutualize the effort by the different regional transport authorities, okay, because it's very important, and it can be one of the economic benefits of this migration, to go out from a fragmented world, most of the time in transport ticketing, to a one which is more mutualized and with a universal approach. The other benefit is that this also opens the possibility to look at a global customer journey. And this year, beginning of summer, the CEO of SNCF, which is the Société Nationale des Chemins de Fer Français, which is the biggest actor by far for ground transport, announced the creation of a program which is named door-to-door transfer, and which states for the fact that SNCF is not only going to look at how to optimize its performance on regional transfers for, regional commuters, not only, continue to develop the high-speed train network and offers, but it's going to look at how you can deliver through mobile an end-to-end customer journey with a consistency in getting your different tickets, also in a consistency in the customer journey. A consistency in the way you also check and validate your ticket. So for sure, we see that as a proof of maturity. We believe that it is this kind of initiative which both will make it more simple to implement NFC, but which also will bring more economic value into the development of it. And for sure, this would not have happened if all the concerned actors in France had not been working very closely on this. And there are other discussions going on, but I cannot, go into the details for obvious reason of time. So for payment, I'm presenting back some numbers by Visa, which we have presented already, which are quite a spectacular development from last year. So when we look at our four main markets, we have close to 1 million POSs accepting mobile payment already as of today. And this is it's such a spectacular development that, to be honest, I am not, even counting back where we were there 12 months, because this, to some point, does not count. What is important is where we'll be in 12 months from now. But what is sure is that we are also approaching, thanks to a common work, the critical mass, which will make it, significant for a customer to use NFC-based mobile payment services. So this effort today, we are working with 20 banks in Europe. And when I say working, in fact, I have to tell you very honestly that it's really a collaboration. It's not just discussing a contract. There is a lot of work. This was also clearly stated in the presentation by China Mobile this morning. There are three aspects which you need to fine-tune to deliver value out of this. So there is one which is very collective, which are security rules, of course, and they have been addressed since the beginning. There is another one, which is how do you optimize the customer journey? Because this customer journey is absolutely key. We promote simplicity, but it's true that if we do not solve the initial customer journey issues, the process to enroll a customer and to get him activated on NFC is not a simple one. So it's a lot of common work, and on this, our partner banks, they are looking for, common solution for some of them, but they are also trying to differentiate them from their competitors. And the third point, I want to cover that also, is the business model. Because also the business model, like for transport, it's sometimes presented as a global issue. But in fact, depending on which country you are, on which type of transport of service you are looking at, so if you talk about debit card and credit card, your business model is completely different. When you are in transport, if you look at the benefits for buses versus metropolitan versus long distance train, in fact, the economic value is absolutely not in the same space from the economic actors. Many times we go into very global assessments about that, and engaging in this world, in this work in detail with each of the actors has enabled us, I think, to make a critical steps forward. So today, one of the major, actors for sure with whom we are trying to, replicate this dynamic is retail. It's absolutely a central and crucial one. And I wanted to, this is my final slide, to comment So maybe we have too much in terms of partnership in France. I like to be, I like a lot my own country. I'm proud to be French. I have to be proud. And but sometimes we have to be a bit also lucid with ourselves. And so you can see that today we have three associations, in fact, running in parallel for NFC. We have the first one, which is the operators one, which is called Association Française du Sans Contact Mobile. I'm the president of it in this moment, but it's on a rotating base. One thing which is very original is in this association is also the operators, let's say, incur the biggest share of the cost of running it, which are not so huge, okay? It's basically for the operators, it's a question of a few hundred thousand of euro per year. So it's much, let's say, cheaper than running any form of JV. What is very interesting in the association is that it's also a way everybody can get into it. So for example, Gemalto is into it, Oberture is into it, SNCF is into it, the French banks are into it. You can get into the association even if you have not started your own NFC program. And so we found it very convenient because this, we need to have an open approach, and it's about partnerships that we can build, let's say, with a structured form, a clear governance, but also in an approach which is open to all actors which want to engage in the development of this service. So we have also Forum des Services Mobiles Sans Contact, which is somehow addressing the same topic. It's a bit less operator-driven, and it's also more focused, let's say, to local authorities and to government bodies. And we have a third association, which is specifically between bankers and mobile operators, which is to agree on the release of POSs, the security issues. So you can see that at this moment, we are running, this effort with three associations in parallel. This might be a bit too complex. Sometimes we think about, let's say, getting back to two. But I wanted to share with you this, this story. So we also run, this is my final word, we are not dogmatic to this. So we have a sister company in EE, which is in a, involved in a JV with, which is a formal JV. And unfortunately, in some markets where there is neither JV nor, nor association, we have found that despite the fact that we have common technical standard, the implementation sometimes gets fragmented. And so the complexity to implement NFC, which we are all working hard at to solve, and I think the presentation of China Mobile this morning was very instructive and very, let's say, I couldn't, let's say, see us back into what was presented. If we fragment, then it's even bigger and the complexity is higher. So in the end, what is important is to fix it. So in countries where we have a fragmentation, because we did not create neither an association nor a JV, we are looking with the GSMA on, let's say, supporting actions with a clear governance, clear legal assessment on how to get the technical implementation on a more, let's say, simple, efficient, and mutualized approach. Thank you very much for your attention.